What's up, everybody? Thank you for stopping by my channel today. My name is Daryl, and I am at a sawmill. Yeah, I'm at Kirkland Sawmill in Kirkland, Illinois. I'm on a little road trip and thought I'd stop by here and pick up a little lumber for the cabinet built-in. I'm working on the drawer faces and making some doors and the little transom area up there at the very top of the built-in. So I'm going to stop in here and pick out some hickory, which is behind me here, and bring that back home and mill it up and start working on this cabinet and see if I can't wrap it up. So that's what I'm doing today. I'm on a little road trip, seeing some family, and that's why I haven't posted some videos in a while. I really haven't been kind of busy, but I thought I would let you know what I'm up to. So let me turn the camera around and I'll show you what we're looking at. All right, we are looking at stacks of hickory here, and I'm making the drawer fronts for those, so I want to make sure that any of the wood that I choose is like what I call a furniture grade wood, and doesn't have a lot of knots and not a lot of sapwood. So I already picked mine out and have it sitting outside, but I just wanted to show you here how organized everything is and how much I appreciate the organization. All through the sawmill here, everything is laid out in the species, and it's very easy to take a look at how long the board is by looking at the writing on the end grain here. So very nice, and it's very hard for me to find this type of organization down where I live. So anyway, I just thought I'd show you what I'm up to today, and maybe tack on a little bit more information onto this video, and maybe some sites that I've seen while I'm up here visiting. But I used to come here a lot when I lived up in this area, and I sure do miss it. I'm telling you, I could spend all day, every day in this at this sawmill, picking out wood for me to make projects out of. Okay, it's a little noisy in here, but this is the sawmill. We're not running it today. This is what cuts all the wood that I buy here. So pretty neat. There's some guys back here surfacing some of the wood, running it through a planer. Real cool. I love it here. I can spend a lot of my time here. Just thought I'd let you see the size of these blades. Probably, I don't know, probably about 3 foot diameter, both of them. And quite a machine. Well, we are packed up. I got my lumber, and you can see it just fit inside the vehicle here. I don't usually pick up lumber with the good car, but I'm doing it this time. And if I need to, I can cut them down. I'll probably end up cutting them down so I don't have to do this, but I'll wait till I get back to where I'm going and cut them down before I make the long trip home. So yes, we got lumber. All right, I'm magically back from my trip. I've brought the wood back to my shop and it's in here. And we're going to get started on these drawer fronts. So let me turn the camera around and I'll show you what's going on. Here's our stack of wood. Now, when I first picked it up from the sawmill, I did not want to drive home with it like that. So these were 10 foot boards of hickory. And I cut them down to 5 foot boards. There's nothing I'm building that's going to be over 5 foot, so I just cut them down so I could stack them in the vehicle better and drive safely. I had about a 5.5 hour drive, so I wanted to make sure that these things weren't moving around in there, so I strapped them together and everything was okay. So, over here on my pad here, I have the dimensions of the drawer fronts that I need. Now, these are rough dimensions.
I'm going to have probably about a 16th of an inch gap around the drawer fronts. So what we're going to do is these here are not wide enough. I'm going to use these for another part of the build. These here down here are going to be the ones I'm going to use for the drawer fronts. I will have to make for the bottom ones, they're 10 3/4 inch tall, and this is not 10 3/4 inch, so I'm going to have to make a bigger board out of these. I'm going to have to cut some down and glue them together and make a wider board. So these drawer fronts are going to be veneered, so I'm looking around for some decent veneer to put on these, but it's very difficult to find any kind of cool looking veneer to put down on hickory. I didn't realize that hickory is really difficult to find any kind of curling or anything like that in the hickory. Something's long enough for us to use for this project, so I'm still searching, but it doesn't look like that's going to happen. So we're going to just veneer with what I got, and if one day comes along and I want to do it differently, I can always pull those off and change the fronts. So that's not a big deal, but let's get this project started. And well, the project started. Let's get this project moving forward, because it's been going on too long. I've got other things like the 6-meter repeater and stuff I want to work on, and I haven't been able to do any of it because this is looming over my head. So let's get this done. So the first thing we need to do is we're going to work on this top drawer. So we need to probably cut some boards down. We need one board at 35 5/8 by 7 3/8. So that is a rough dimension. I will fit them in there, and then we'll get our 16th inch reveal, and then it'll be ready for veneering. So I don't know if I'm going to do that before I veneer, or veneer and then cut them down to size. We'll see. But let's get this at least cut out. Alright, I got everything milled roughly. I got a reference edge on each end and then each side. So I put the R for reference. So that's my square. That tells me that this edge and this end are square to each other. And that's the reference edge that I'll work off of for every cut that I make. So these are our three drawer blanks, drawer front blanks, and this one here is what I'm going to trim down. I'm going to trim this down and add it to these to make my 10 3/4 inch wide drawer front. So that's what I'm going to do next. I'm going to cut this one down to the proper length, and then we'll glue those pieces onto these two bottom boards. And that's going to give me the width I need for the two bottom drawers. So let's do that now. Alright, I got our parts roughly milled and stickered, and I'll leave that set for about a day, maybe two, but probably one, and see if they move any. So by moving, I mean, are they going to twist or warp, or, you know, since I've cut them up a little bit, they might have a little bit of movement to them. So we'll see if they move. If they don't, then we'll commence to moving forward with this particular thing. These two pieces here, they got to be glued to these parts here. Oops, these parts here. So these get glued on, this one gets glued on here and makes that wider. So we will let them set overnight and see what happens to them. So since we have a little bit of time, and I have other parts that I need to mill for this, let's move on to the doors. Now the doors are roughly just the frames to the doors are the stiles and rails. So I think, I'm not really sure how wide I want there. So if we pretend like one of these is one of the stiles of rails, and I get my measuring tape out. This is around 2 inches here. Well, it's 2 inches. So I'll probably rough cut my rails to about 2.5 inch. And then I'll do the same thing. I'll sticker them up and let them set here. So we're making stiles and rails for two doors. And then there'll be a plywood panel in there, which also will be veneered. So let's make these stiles and rails, and we'll get those stickered. And then if I'm not working on one thing, like when I glue these up, then I can go back to working on the doors. So let's do that. So let's mill that up. And when I'm not going to show that, because you've already seen me mill this. So I will mill those up, and we'll come back. And then the next video, we'll glue these boards together and then work on the doors a little bit, I guess. I have all my parts here laid out and stickered. And like I said, we'll let this set a day or so and see if anything moves. And then we'll run them back through the jointer and the planer. And then we will veneer them. And after we veneer them, then we'll cut them to the size. So we're coming along here. I didn't have as much wood as I thought I was going to have. I do have some left, but I do have enough to finish the project, but I thought I'd have a whole lot left over, but I do not. So I have to be really careful when I start my milling and everything that I don't mess anything up. So cross your fingers I don't do that. So when we come back again, we will glue these up, these two bottom ones up, to make them wider and get those surfaced. And then these here, we'll run them again through the jointer and the planer and get those all nice and flat. And then we will start the veneering process. So I got to go through my veneer and make sure that I have enough to do this. And then after that, we got the transom little decorative thing up there at the very top that I need to figure out what I'm going to do. I thought about just making a frame and maybe some frosted glass in there or something. We will see. And then I got to build a light, but that's not an emergency, the light. But this is kind of an emergency because I want to get it done. So that's where we're at now. All right. Kind of a short video. But yeah, we're moving along here. These projects like that, they take a while. You know, I could make one long video or short videos. I think short videos are better than long ones. You know, I could draw this thing out for an hour
but you don't want to see that. So I will let it go here. I'll stop this video here, and we'll come back and start the other process, and I'll go through my veneer and make sure I have enough. If I don't, I'm going to have to order some. And the only reason why I'm veneering it is because I want a uniform grain across the whole cabinet, and the hickory that I've been finding has not been too great looking for me. I'm kind of picky, so I want that to be a nice nice knot free kind of frame to go around that front of the cabinet. So that's why we're doing that. I looked for something that had a lot of maybe curl in it, some figure in it, but very difficult to try to find, even at the sawmill. It was really difficult. So we'll just go with what we can do. So anyway, this cabinet, I have no doubt that this cabinet will outlast me. It will outlast the next person who buys this house. And hopefully well over 100 years, this cabinet will still be going strong. So I'm not building it to fall apart. I'm not building it cheaply. As you see, I'm using real hickory hardwood to make the cabinet doors and drawer faces and everything. Even though we're veneering it, it's still all hickory. So when I go to put all the parts on it that I'm making right now, I'm hoping that I enjoy the look of that, because I really wanted to find that figured veneer, but I could not. So I'm still on the lookout for it. If I find anything, I'll order it and get it in here, but right now I have not gotten anything that's big enough. I found some, but nothing that's long enough for this project. So I'm really kind of upset about that. I really thought that I'd be able to find it, and I was not happy when I was unable to find that easily. So I'll still look, and we'll see what I come up with. But anyway, if you like this kind of content, like and subscribe to my channel. Hit the thumbs up. That's great. Leave a comment. I love the comments, good or bad. Just leave them. A lot of people have their own opinion about things. That's fine. Everybody's entitled to their own opinion. And worst comes to worst, I just ignore it. Ignore your comment. Or I probably will just respond anyway, but that's fine. If you were in the room with me, would you make that comment? I don't know. If you did, then I would have a chance to tell you why I'm doing a certain thing. So just pretend like you're in the room with me and you're asking this question and leaving a comment. That'd be great. Thank you very much for being here today, and we'll see you next time. Goodbye.